I would now request all the members to kindly stand up for the silent prayer. The vision statement. We'll endeavor to transform the state of Kerala to a vibrant economy with inclusive growth that emulates world standards in every sphere. Thank you. As per the customary practice, we always begin our meetings and sessions with the lighting of the lamp. I would request Chairman to kindly light the traditional lamp. I would also request our former chairman, please come forward, as well as conveners of the ladies forum as well as youth forum. Please come forward. From Calicut region and other committee members from Northern region, honorable members, and ladies and gentlemen, I have great pleasure to welcome you all on this 55th AGM of the chamber. We are all on the level creating history. Few days from now, His Excellency Pranab Kumar Mukherjee, President of India, would formally inaugurate the Kerala Trade Center, our dream project and prestigious project of Kerala Chamber of Commerce and Industry. All of us would be proud of this unique and remarkable achievement. The last 1 year was very eventful and fruitful. The first thing, the newly appointed Direct Board when took charge, introduced to conduct daily meetings from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. in the evening every day. Office bearers, directors who could spare time could make themselves available in the chamber for interactions with members, visitors and from themselves. You are all aware the Kerala Chamber has presence at various centers in Kerala, promoting and developing trade and industry and functions as a central forum for business, truly interacting our vision, the vision statement in transforming Kerala into a vibrant economy. The gross domestic product, that is GDP, in India declined from 7.8% in 2011 to 6.5% in 2012. The appreciation of rupees against dollar was the main cause for financial worry for the government. But the situation has eased out by the end of 2012. It was 7.24% in last November. Indian economy needs further opening, but adequate safeguards need to be taken to protect the domestic industry wherever required. It is learned that central government is seriously considering to introduce schemes whereby small and medium retail entrepreneurs would be provided soft loans so as to create a level playing ground while taking up the challenge of multinational companies entering into the retail sector. As you are aware, KCC has taken many issues concerning the economy, industry, trade, logistics, etc., to the concerned authorities in the central government and state government regularly. Issues is commenced in the media when a new development takes place. Or policy interactive is taken on when the economic situation deteriorates. I am proud to state that KCCA played a prominent role in obtaining recent relaxation in the cabotage rules for ICTT at Walla border. The delegation of KCCA was in Delhi in the first week of December 2012 and held an important discussion with concerned ministers and appraised them the gravity of the situation, which culminated in the relaxation of rules of ICTT Walla border. Despite our concerted efforts over a period of time, many potential investors have not enough confidence to invest in Kerala due to various factors such as militant in labor, non-availability of sufficient fund, red tape in bureaucracy, not prompt clearance to object projects by different departments on time, etc. Emerging Kerala was organized by the Government of Kerala in September 2012 and various investment proposals worth crores of rupees were received. But what we need is that bold initiatives from the government for the faster clearance of economically viable investment proposals so that these investment proposals do not remain only in papers. The need of the hour of the state government is that it should take bold initiative for speedy clearance of worthy investment proposal under single window scheme. Bold policy initiatives in Kerala: Land Reforms Act, land ceiling restrictions. The government should do away with its prohibitive power tariff and came out with attractive schemes in power sector conducive for trade and industry. We are glad to note that KCCA is represented in almost all high-level decision bodies and committees in the state government. Our nominees are actively participating in these forms, giving effective policy direction to the government. I also specially thank former chairman Sri K. M. Abdullah, Sri E.S. Jose, Sri John K. Paul and Deepak L. Aswani for their timely advice and suggestions. A big word of thanks to all Agenda Fair committee members also. Special thanks are also due to Dr. Vishu Ramesh, President, KCCA Southern Region, and Mr. Ashik Parol, President, KCCA Northern Region, for their support and cooperation during the last 1 year. I also thank Mr. Shafiq, convener, KCCA Youth Forum and exclusive committee members. Mr. Jyoti Ashwani, convener, KCCA Ladies Forum and executive committee members, for their support and cooperation extended to me. No clap. I thank members of KCCA for their support and cooperation turning up in large numbers in most of the events of KCCI. No organization can move without the active involvement of members. Do continue to extend the same support in the coming years too. I also place my thanks to the honorable ministers of central and state government, officials of the central and government, state government, etc. District collector, worshipful mayor of Kuchin, local government organization, all those organizations who joined hand and associated with KCCI, holding events, programs in association with us, and all our well wishers. I must also sincerely thank the responsibility of the press and media for giving wide coverage to the various activities of the chamber last year. I also thank Secretary of KCCI, Mr. Xavier Matthew, and managers of various departments and staff of the Chamber Secretariat for their support and cooperation during my tenure. During the past 1 year, as the chairman of KCCI, I tried to bring in new energy to KCCI and give a new direction. I cannot overwhelmingly state that I have done justice to my post, but whatever achievements and contributions I could make during the last 1 year would be continued in the years to come. I am sure the new leadership would definitely pursue the unaccomplished task and new challenges. I shall always be available to offer my assistance whenever and wherever required for the Kerala Chamber of Commerce.
Thank you.